Hello everyone, welcome to the course of computer network specifically for the GATE purpose. In this lecture we will discuss about the next sliding window protocol, that is selective repeat ARQ. We have already discussed about the go back n protocol, which is also a sliding window protocol. Okay, we will discuss about selective repeat. Okay, let's see what we will cover in this lecture. We will see some drawbacks of the go back n, and then we will see how actually selective repeat ARQ works, and we will then discuss some important points about the selective repeat ARQ. Okay, let's start with the drawback of go back n. So the first drawback of go back n is, in go back n, if one frame is lost, then sender also need to resend all the followed frame. If one frame is lost, actually we know that if one frame is lost, sender was sending the complete window frame, like 1, 2, 3, 4. If one is lost, then that was also retransmitting these followed frames, not only the lost frame. Okay, so that was the problem there. And for noisy channels, go back n is the worst flow control method. If the channel is noisy, in that case retransmitting the complete window, that can lead to the worst flow control method. Okay, that makes the go back n as a worst flow control method. So what can be the solution for this? The easy solution can be if we can transmit only the losted frame, rather than sending all the frame in the window, if we can transmit only one frame, then that can be the best solution. Actually, that is the method used in the selective repeat. See, if a frame is lost, only retransmitting the frame that is lost, only that frame retransmitting will be the best solution. Yes, and selective repeat works on the same principle, that retransmit only that frame which is losted, not all the frames present in the window. Okay, not the followed frame. Okay, so this will reduce the number of frame that is transmitted. Okay, so let's see now the working of the selective repeat ARQ, how selective repeat ARQ work. We already know actually selective repeat ARQ, how that is different from go back and stop and wait due to this thing. What is this? The size of the sender window is equal to size of the receiver window in selective repeat ARQ. While in the go back n, window size of sender window size is n and receiver window size is 1, but here both are same. In selective repeat, sender and receiver window size is same. See, let me show you with the example. This is sender timeline, this is receiver timeline. Okay, let's suppose the sender and receiver window is 4. Let me take an example. So the sequence number will be like this: 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, again 0 1 2, so on. Why I'm writing the sequence number up to 7? Because we know that sequence number is equal to window, so sender window plus size of sender window plus size of receiver window. So here we are assuming that sender window and receiver windows are 4, so total is actually 8. 4 plus 4 8 should be the sequence number, distinct sequence number should be 8. So 0 to 7 is distinct sequence number is 8 now, 0 1 2 3 4 up to 7. Again, then I will start with 0, 0 to 7, then again 0 to 7. Okay, so receiver window also will look like same: 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, again 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Okay, so let's see now how actually selective repeat work. Actually, I will explain only the case one right now. Case one of selective repeat, how selective repeat work. Only the one first case. In first case, actually, in first case we explain how successfully everything is working successfully. Nothing is getting lost. No frame is lost. No acknowledgement is lost. Everything is sent by the sender, is received by the receiver. Everything is going fine. That is actually case one. In every protocol, I am using the same approach. Okay. So see, because the window size is 4, so 4 frame will be transmitted back to back. 0, 1, 2, 3. 0, 1, 2, 3. So this is our window actually. This is the sender window. This is the receiver window. Okay. And the moment the 0th frame is received by the receiver, that will send an acknowledgement for that. And after sending the acknowledgement, that will shift the window one step. Okay. And after receiving the acknowledgement, sender will also shift the window. Okay. We know this thing. After receiving the acknowledgement for 0, so 0 will be out of the window. In the current window, we will insert 4. So 4 will be transmitted. Okay. Then after that, okay, this is 1 actually, this is not 4, this is 1. So, 1 acknowledgement will be sent, and here the window will shift like this. Okay, and here also the window will shift like this. And so on, this will keep going on. This will transmit it fifth frame, and here the receiver will send the acknowledgement for 2nd, and window will shift here like this. And after receiving the acknowledgement for 2 will be out of the window, and 6 will be inside the window, and 6 will be transmitted. So this process will keep going on. This is actually case 1. Everything is going very fine. This is sender is sending the data, and receiver is receiving everything and fine, and sending the acknowledgement. Okay. And the window is sliding one by one. Okay. Important part here is two different thing. If you compare it with the go back and is here, window size both side is same. Receiver is also having 4 window size here. Okay. And another thing is here the number of sequence number will be WS plus WR. Okay. So this is the case one. Let's see the case two of selective repeat ARQ. Okay. In selective repeat ARQ, actually in case 2 we have two cases, case 2.1 and case 2.2. Let's see first case 2.1. According to case 2.1, if a frame is lost, then only the lost frame will be retransmitted after timeout time. Okay, one thing is clear, only one frame we are going to retransmit in selective repeat. Okay, let me show you this point with the help of this timeline diagram. Let me make it little small. This is sender, this is receiver, and let me take the window size is 4 as previous example. So the sequence number will be 0 to 7. 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, again start from 0 1 2 3 and so on. Okay, so here also 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 0 1 2, so on. Okay, so this will transmit these 4 frames. So 0 1 2 3 4 3 4 0 1 2 3. Okay, so these are transmitted according to case 1. Let's suppose a frame is lost. Let's suppose this second frame is lost in between. That do not reach to the receiver. All other are reached here. Okay. Second frame is lost. Then what will happen? Sender will wait for some time. Some time means timeout time. Sender will wait for timeout time. And at that time, actually, that will resend the second frame. Okay, so So this is how actually selective repeat work if a frame is lost. So only second one is recent, not the followed one. Okay, so which one will the followed one? Okay, let me complete this timeline diagram. So 0 is sent here, that will send the acknowledgement for that. Let me send the acknowledgement. So this will be now 4 will be sent back, and 1 is received. So 1 is also acknowledgement is sent, and then this will transmit the fifth one. Okay, but 2 is not received, so no acknowledgement can be sent by the receiver. Okay, but the fourth one is received, so the acknowledgement for fourth one and third one actually can be sent. Okay, so because after fifth one, then sixth will be sent, and after the seventh will be sent. In between, see, in between we are sender is sending the second one also after timeout. So this is how actually selective repeat is working. Okay, if a frame is lost, the receiver actually don't know. Receiver is thinking that frame is in the way. Okay, so that's why he not sending any acknowledgement for that. But sender wait for timeout time, and once the timeout time start will from here, from 2. Timeout time will end for 2, that retransmit the second packet. The thing is, only second packet will be, only the losted packet will be retransmitted, not the followed packet 4, 5 or 6, 7. Nothing is transmitted. I do not show how window is sliding. Important part is this in the second. Okay, how losted packet will be retransmitted. Okay, so this is actually case 2.1. If a frame is lost, only losted packet will be retransmitted after timeout time. Okay. So there is one more case in this, actually case 2.2. In the case 2 itself, there is another case. If the frame is corrupted, this was the frame lost, but if the frame is corrupted, means frame reached to the destination or receiver, but that is corrupted frame. Okay, then what will happen? Then corrupted frame will be retransmitted immediately after receiving negative acknowledgement. Okay, let me explain it with the timeline diagram. What this 2.2 case is saying, this is our sender, this is our receiver. Okay, and let me write the sequence number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, again 0, 1, so on. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 0, so on. Okay, so this send the frame, first window is this one. So send all the frame 0, 1, 2, 3. 0, 1, 2, 3. We were talking about the second frame. Okay, so let's suppose 0 frame reached, first frame reached, second frame reach here, but second frame is corrupted. Okay, second frame is corrupted, not lost, that reached to the receiver, but that is corrupted, because receiver receive the second frame, that will send a acknowledgement for that. Okay, so that will send a acknowledgement for that, and that acknowledgement will be the negative acknowledgement, NAC, negative acknowledgement of 2. Second frame is corrupted. This acknowledgement, what sender will think that, okay, this particular frame is corrupted, then it need to resend it again. It need to resend the second frame again. Okay, see, let me complete this diagram with all the frames and acknowledgements. So here the acknowledgement of 0 will be received here, so fourth frame will be sent. Okay, and then the fifth frame will be sent. Okay, so actually after this the acknowledgement of second will come. Okay, and after this you can say, okay, next packet you can transmit from here, fourth one, fifth one, and so on. Okay, the important part here is that according to this statement, Here the receiver is sending the negative acknowledgement after receiving the corrupted frame. Okay, so what is the benefit of sending the negative acknowledgement? Here also we automatically after timeout the sender is sending retransmitting the second frame only. Here is also retransmitting the second frame. Why it is, what is the use of sending the negative acknowledgement? Actually, by sending the negative acknowledgement, the benefit is sender immediately transmit the second frame. Here it receives the negative acknowledgement and immediately transmit the second frame. But let's suppose this is not transmitting the negative acknowledgement. If the receiver is not transmitting the negative acknowledgement, in that case, this may happen. This may be the timeout time. This may be the timeout time of second frame. At second frame, if negative acknowledgement is not there, then sender only will send the second frame at this point. Okay, so second frame need to wait this much more time to be resent. Okay, but in the case of negative acknowledgement, sender is immediately sending the frame, required frame. Okay, so simple point is that negative acknowledgement is helping to retransmit the lost frame immediately. See, if the frame is corrupted means that reached to the receiver but that is corrupted, then the corrupted frame will be retransmitted. Then corrupted frame will be retransmitted immediately, not waiting for up to timeout time. Okay, after receiving the negative acknowledgement. One more point here in negative acknowledgement is that the number here will be of lost frame, not of the next frame. In the normal acknowledgement, we write the number of the next frame, required frame here. But in the case of negative acknowledgement, we write this number as the number of lost frame. Okay, so this is the case 2 of selective repeat. Let's see now the case 3. In case 3, acknowledgement is lost. If acknowledgement is lost, only one frame will be retransmitted. That's it, very simple actually. Let me show you. This is sender, this is receiver. Let's suppose window size is 4. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 0, 1, so on. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 0, 1, so on. And this is our window. These frames are sent. 0, 1, 2, 3. Let's suppose acknowledgement for this is received, but this is lost, second one. Okay, we are taking second one every time. Okay, so if this is lost, okay, then what will happen? Simple. Sender will wait for timeout time. Okay, and retransmit the second frame. And meanwhile, that is transmitting other frames also after receiving the acknowledgement. Okay, so 6 here, and maybe after receiving this, that is sending fourth one here and fifth one here. So sending acknowledgement for that. Important part here is that simply is that if the acknowledgement of this frame is lost, second one is lost, sender will wait for some time for timeout time and retransmit the second frame. That's it. That is the third case. Okay, that is the third case. Okay, let's move on. Let me share some important points with you about the selective repeat ARQ. So first point is that in selective repeat ARQ, sender window size should be greater than 1. Why sender window size should be greater than 1? Because if you are setting sender window size as 1, then we know that sender window size is equal to receiver window size in selective repeat, then both will be 1. If this is the case, this is nothing, just stop and wait actually. This will behave like stop and wait ARQ. If you will set both of them to, if we will set sender window size as 1, then that receiver's window size will also be 1 because both are same. Because both are same, selective repeat, sender window size and receiver window size. So that will work as stop and wait. So if that is set 1, then it will behave as stop and wait. So that should be greater than 1 if we are talking about selective repeat ARQ. Otherwise that will become stop and wait. Okay, and we already know this thing, window size of sender and receiver is same. Okay, third point is selective repeat ARQ can accept out of order frames. Okay, so if you are sending 0 frame, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 0 1 2, so on, two frame is corrupted, it's okay, you can resend it later on. Okay, receiver will receive that in any order. Okay, receiver will receive that in any order. Okay, so selective repeat ARQ can accept out of order frames. Okay, stop and wait ARQ go back and always accept in order frames. Okay, they accept these, both of them accept in order frames. Frame must be in order because receiver window size is 1 there actually. Okay, they are receiving only 1 frame at a time. Okay, but in selective repeat, if something is lost, okay, it's no problem, that can be sent later on. And in, even though you have already sent third, fourth, fifth, here you can send second one again. Okay, that will receive it actually. Okay, and I will add one more point here that is not written here. In selective repeat ARQ, receiver, here is the sender, here is the receiver. Receiver must have the capability of sorting. Okay, receiver must be able to sort the frames. Okay. So this is the this should be the capability of the receiver, and sender capability must be of searching. Okay, if one frame is lost, then it need to search that frame into the buffer. Okay, that this is lost, this is need to retransmit. Okay, so searching feature must be there with the sender, and sorting feature must be there at the receiver. That's why this selective repeat is more expensive. Okay, take more time to work as compared to go back end. Okay, because receiver need to perform sorting, because that is receiving in any order, but that need to provide the frames in order to the upper layer. Okay, actually everything is happening at the data link layer. We know that this is flow control method which works as the data link layer, but data link layer need to provide all the frames in sorted order to the network layer. So for that, sorting need to be done, okay, at the sender side. And because we need to retransmit second frame, so in the buffer, sender need to search the second frame to retransmit in case frame is lost. Okay, so this leads to make the selective repeat little bit more expensive in term of take more time to processing. Okay, let's take another point. Retransmission are very less in selective repeat ARQ as compared to go back end. Yes, here we are only transmitting in selective repeat, we are retransmitting one frame only, which is lost. But in the case of go back end, complete window is retransmitted. So less number of retransmission are going on. Okay, let's move on. Okay, that's it about this lecture. Thank you.